CSI Stockbrokers has released its year-ahead report for 2014. We'll take a look at the broad consumer space forecast with Adedayo Ayeni, Equity Research Analyst at CSL Stockbrokers. Thank you so much, Adedayo, for taking the time out to join us.
Thank you for having me.
Well, let's start with your position on Guinness. You're not too bullish on the stock this year, and you did. And according to your report, the company will be facing some major challenges. Could you bring us up to speed on that?
Thank you very much. Guinness Nigeria has struggled to increase volumes of beer over the last 2 years, and we don't see any improvements in the current period. For Guinness Nigeria particularly, its core markets where it is really strong in terms of volumes, the Southwest and some parts of the Southeast, there's been increased competition from the likes of SAB Miller's Interfac Brewery and also international breweries in the Southwest. And this has led to Guinness seeing some form of squeeze in volumes that it has shipped over the last 6 months to 1 year. And what we're forecasting for them this year is that sales should decline just by about 4%. And more interestingly is that if we dig this down the P&L just further down, because some of the additional capacity that Guinness brought on stream in November 2013 was financed by debt. Some of these debts, the interest charge on them was previously capitalized, and going forward, it will be expensed. And once this is expensed, Guinness's profit should be pressured going into FY 2014. We're forecasting that Guinness should see some squeeze in profits by about 25% PBT, that is.
Now, Daya, that's quite interesting because Guinness, it's a big company, it's a huge brand, and I'm wondering how it was able to lose some of that market share. Now, you've just mentioned one or two challenges. Do you think that this stock or the company could bounce back soon?
It is possible if Guinness sees some improvement in sales, but we don't see that, particularly given the fact that SAB Miller is talking about additional capacity, and not only additional capacity to continue to produce cheap brew. And cheap brew is what is really selling in this market now. If you look at the results of the three listed brewers that are under coverage, Nigerian breweries, Guinness and international breweries, you just see that that the momentum is on the side of international breweries. Guinness particularly isn't doing so well, just in our view, because of the fact that it carries mainly premium brands, and premium brands, they are not doing so well in the market right now. The value brands are outselling the premium brands, and the only reason why Nigerian breweries is able to see some volume growth, in our opinion, is just because of some of the brands I acquired in October 2011 from Sona Breweries, and these brands are primarily value brands.
Now, you've put a sell position on this stock, Guinness. How do you see investors reacting to this stock going forward?
There's been some derating since we published, and when we published, the stock price was at 235. And earlier in late last year, when we published our notes prior to this, it was somewhere around 250. And as at yesterday, I think it closed around to 218, 219. But going forward, I still expect some derating, because once the Guinness releases its half year 2014 results, we don't expect anything fantastic from there, and we expect investors to further react. The brewer stocks have actually derated. Nigerian breweries also is down. International breweries is down slightly, but in terms of overall shedding of stock price, Guinness has really shed some compared to the other guys.
Now, you're quite bullish on the flour mills, food stocks, as it were. Tell us why you're bullish on flour mills for this year. Does it have anything to do with the increase in the capacity for this year?
Increase in capacity and just our overall thesis for the year for the companies that are involved in the production of basic food staples, really. Over the last 3 years and for our forecast, we've seen that, and what we've seen over the last 3 years is that these guys, that's flour mills, Honeywell flour, they've hauled in growth, sales growth, top line, in excess of inflation, and not by 200 basis points, 300 basis points, significant top line growth. And going forward, we expect that the likes of Honeywell flour and flour mills, particularly flour mills, considering that it has all its acquisition that it has brought on its books, and we just expect to see an improvement in food sales from this company. While this has not flowed down the P&L line, just because of the same reason that I gave for Guinness, but unlike Guinness's case, where Guinness isn't really seeing top line growth, flour mills is growing significantly. Organic growth for it, even as at half year, was in excess of 12%, and that is impressive. So the additional cost of bringing on the golden sugar operations, of depreciation, expensed interest charges that were on the balance sheet as capitalized prior to now, we'll see some squeeze in profits. But in excess of FY 2014, we think that this company should be able to see improvements in profits. But sales, they are very solid.
Thank you so much, Adedayo, for that insight into what to expect according to your report. I do think we can take one more question just before I let you go. Now, we know that what's going on in the broader economy, a lot of uncertainty, particularly in the financial space. Now, we know that food stocks are traditionally safe haven stocks. So for these two stocks, Honeywell and Flour Mills, do you think that they could serve as good safe haven stocks for investors if we see this turbulence in the market continuing?
In terms of what we expect for the two stocks, we expect that investors will see the value flow through for these two companies. They are in the same sector, but Flour Mills is more of a diversified company. It is really making efforts to backward integrate. We think that the cost challenges that it is seeing right now and some of the operational challenges, it will overcome some of them next year. And Honeywell just focuses on just, you know, efficiency and just maintaining its margins. It has gone into the production of noodles, and its noodles is really gaining traction in the market space. So we expect that investors will see the value in these companies come through and really understand that these companies are growth companies going forward, and then they will get into them.
Now, going forward, we know that, like I mentioned, the banking index, banking stocks still a lot under pressure going forward. Do you see more investors, particularly portfolio investors, when balancing out their portfolio, do you see them putting more of consumer goods stocks such as these in their portfolio and reducing their stake in bank stocks?
I think so. While I cannot talk much on the banking stocks, just on the back of the fact that investors over the last 2 to 3 weeks have pulled out on some of these banking stocks, and this has flowed to us basically from the fears of the, tapering in the United States and just general fears about emerging markets. But also, the good part of it is that for the consumer names, there's been some derating, and that is significant, especially for the likes of Nigerian Breweries and Guinness. While the likes of Flour Mills and Honeywell Flour has really stayed strong, we do expect that over the next couple of weeks, investors will ask more questions about these companies as they seek to diversify their portfolios.
Many thanks, Adedayo. We're going to have to leave it there. Thank you for that insight into your report for 2014. That was Adedayo Ayeni, Equity Research Analyst at CSL Stockbrokers.